Well, hey, my fellow people of the interweb, stuff like that, I'm Demon, and welcome back to another episode of Let's Play Sly 2, Band of Thieves. In the last episode, we did, surprisingly, two missions. One of them was, like, that, Sly-Murray Conspire, yeah, well, whatever. Because that Bentley one is called, like, the Bentley-Murray Conspire thingamajigger. It's, like, Team Up, I don't even know. There's so many different names for it, but whatever, we did that mission, and the TNT run, which is all sped up and made my voice sound all cool-like and stuff. Well, I mean, not cool, but it made it sound kind of weird. So anyways, this episode we're going to be starting with this one, which is basically Sly Bentley Conspire. They're okay.
To disable that engine room, you and I are going to have to work together.
Happy to have you along, Bentley. What do you need me to do?
Pickpocket the guard's keys to the engine room. Once you've got the door open, I'll take over.
Okay, you should take your position. It's not going to take me long to lighten these guys of their keys.
Yeah, a cool fact about actually this right here is that, right here, this is actually the part that I actually ended this LP on my old channel. Yeah, it's kind of surprising that, like, this LP is, like, I'm part 39. I mean, I'm almost done with the LP. It's just that on my old channel, I went through it faster. But then again, I did kind of speedrun and had, like, a random 24-minute episodes at times, which I thought was kind of useless, but yeah. But anyways, going on to the game and all the game and stuff and how who inhabits it, we are going to... I mean, we have to actually collect 5 of keys. I almost said, like, 5 of 7, but we have to collect 5 of 5 keys, and we have 1 of 5 keys, and yeah. And that guard's gonna see me? Yes, he did, okay. And this is just perfectly fine. Let's just try to kill these guys here. Come on, kill the guys, because these guys are a pain in the butt, because they, like, fly up with their, like, flame and jetpack thing, and I don't know, I just really do not like these guards. Like, they really boot up the power of the guards. Like, see right there? Like, that can happen. You'll just boot off right there, and it gets really annoying. And wait, is there another guy here? And, yep, there is. Aw, come on! There we go, now all of them are done and destroyed. Now, what we have to do here is a little bit tricky. I'm not so sure if I can pull this off, but, let's see, can I pull this off? See, can I? And, oh yeah, I can. Okay, that's actually pretty cool. I usually can never pull that off. So let's just kind of walk away like that. Okay, that's like a first. Usually what you want to do is you want to have, like, the alarm clock to lure him away. But you can be sneaky like that and get him like that. There is one where you have to be very sneaky or whatever, but that's, you can do that. I never usually do that, because that's why I was kind of worrying about that one guy. But we actually did it with, like, no time flat, so that's awesome. I don't know, but then again, I knew you could do that. I was just kind of, like, wondering, like, okay, is that gonna happen? And yay, there's actually another guard right here, so let's just catch up to him by running in a circle, yeah. And this is actually a little bit of, like, a different thing, because this is actually a Monday, and I'm only gonna be recording one episode, because this is, like, the week I have, like, finals and stuff, and basically what I have to do is just, I don't know, I'm just gonna have to record this and edit it tonight, and then have it, like, render and upload tomorrow. Just because I promised I was going to have a video up on Tuesday and Thursday this week. Like, this episode, like, which is part 39! And I did not, I meant to kill you! Thank you, okay. Whew. That didn't work out. Oh, come on, there's a guard found. Wait, where is it? Where? Okay, there's no, and I just got a random bottle. Okay, where's the other ones we have to go? There's one over there, okay. Oh, we only need 2 more. Damn, I thought we needed a lot more than that, so... He is right over there, so I'm not sure if this is the best idea. And ooh, Clocklo was down there, if you saw her down there flying like a weird guy. And, nope. You can actually stand by and hit these until one of them comes out, but that's probably the retard thing to do. And is he gonna come down here? Nope, he's not. We can just sneak up right there. And then we got to the next key, which that... I really don't even know how they program these guys in order to have, like, okay, this guy's gonna have this amount of coins in him and, like, this amount of pickpocketing, but whatever. We only need 1 more key, and it's only 4 minutes into the episode, and, okay, how the hell did that guard find me? Was he, like, on, I don't even know what it was. Why am I going up here? I mean, well, I know I'm going up here. I met, like, I didn't know why I was going to the other area, so next one guy is right over there, and we should get him in no time flat. Also, watch out for that. I've never gotten his light. I mean, Clockless light, but I'm pretty sure that light will actually make you die. And hopefully... Wait, is this the one that's on fire? I don't know if this is the one you have to actually get close to, but I'm pretty sure this is the key you want to get last, but Like I said, I am not certain about this, but whatever. Now, this is the one I said you could kind of sneak up on. I mean, this one's pretty easy. The only thing you have to do is just get a little close like that, and then just pickpocket him like this. And we got the engine room key number 5. Now, where do we have to go to actually get to the next one? Okay, the next one is over there. Okay, never mind, because I was pretty sure this is the one we exploded, isn't it? Wait, is it? Yep, it is, because you can see the fire up there. That's the one we exploded with the TNT barrel, which I usually can never see that, because I always do that TNT barrel mission last, for some odd reason of oddness and proportion. And why did I fly down here? Damn it. Oh, okay, I guess I'm just going to have to run back up there, which I'm pretty sure I can just go way over here and get that. I was going to cut that out, but I was thinking, you know, I really don't need to cut this out, because it's not that much far of backtracking. Then again, I do overuse the running mechanic in this game, because as you've seen, I really don't care if guards catch me or not. I just run whenever I want to, because the running's meant for, like, if you get caught by a guard if you're running, but I don't know. Whatever, and there's this weird thing, whenever I talk, it makes this weird thing in my ear of my headset, and it's getting annoying. Actually, speaking of headsets, I was going to bring this up, but I wasn't going to bring it up after, like, I said that, but, because I do not play in my commentary, but I'm going to say that, I'm very happy that it's actually very close to my birthday as of recording this, because as of recording this, it is, like, yeah, it's 2 days until my birthday, but anyways, now we got put all the 5 keys there, but yeah. And since for main thing I asked for on my birthday was a blue snowball microphone, the reason I asked for that is just because I really want a new microphone, because I thought, you know, a new microphone is going to be actually pretty cool for me, and it'll be awesome. And now actually thinking of it, it was actually a good idea starting with this pair. So now what we have to do here is we have to actually hit these things, which is basically just a whole different thing. Like, you cannot hit different, like, simultaneously or whatever. You have to hit, like, certain ones above a certain thing. See if we can get this one right there. Like, see, now we have to actually hit that one like that. It is actually pretty easy to do. It's not, like, super hard. It's not, like, the hardest thing in the world you're ever gonna face. Okay, and... okay, okay, that was actually very close. I thought I wasn't gonna get that, but I got that. No problem. I mean, it's not really super hard, but it's actually pretty cool how they, like, maneuver the darts to actually do this. It's, like, a pretty cool mechanic. Actually, a little fact is that when I first played this part, I got here and I'm like, what are you supposed to do? You're like, are you supposed to do something? Then I'm like, oh, you have to listen to Murray when he talks, because Murray does talk if you actually heard him. I don't know if he actually heard him, but he actually did talk. But yeah, it actually gets very easier once you get down to, like, the last few, because you have less ones to worry about accidentally getting in your way. So yeah, you might want to take your time if you're a beginner, but since I'm not really that much of a beginner, I can kind of do this any way I want. Also, if you do fail at this, you're going to have to start that part all over again. And let me just get this on the comeback here. And come back. There we go. Aw, come on. No. There we go. That's better. That's the one. Now, I believe we have 2 more question mark. And can I get this one? Yep, I can. Okay, and now once you have this last one here, you don't have to worry about anything, because I'm pretty sure you cannot fail once you have just one left. I mean, if I can actually get this one, then I can say you're not going to have to fail. Okay, can I get this one right here? No. God damn it, can I hit this? Can I hit this? Thank you. And now, can I hit this right here? It just all depends. Frick! Okay, I kind of am contradicting myself to see if I can hit this, but... am I going to have to wait another round for this to come up? Thank you, okay, that's better. Now after that, you see these little light things actually come out, and... man, I think I spent like a minute on just that one. And now, I'm pretty sure once you jump up here, what you have to do is you have to actually bomb these things. But don't worry about these, like, helicopters that come up. The only thing you have to do is just bomb these. It's nothing big. Just need to keep running around and putting a bomb on these things. Like I said, don't worry about the helicopters, because they will do you no harm if you just keep running! Okay, that was actually close to doing harm, but whatever. And now, hopefully that should be all of them, and now let's just wait for those things to blow up. Okay, there we go. Now we have to make it over there, which is this one right here, and let's go over there to turn down the thing. And this one I find actually a lot easier than the other.
One less engine for that creepy clockla thing to draw power from.
Yeah, I know I kind of went silent there. I kind of wanted you to, like, hear the rest of the cutscene, but I kind of didn't know. And man, 92% done with the game. Just a fact, I know it's not really a spoiler, but once you actually finish the game, you actually finish it with 99% if you did not collect all the bottles, which... I am not doing a bottle montage because I never collected all the bottles in this game. I never will want to collect all the bottles in Sly 2. Just because, like, people thought that Sly 4, it was awesome that they brought back the bottles, because in Sly 3 they didn't have them. But It's just, I really don't care about the bottles, because the bottles are annoying to find. I mean, Sly 1, I can handle them. They're easy to find in Sly 1. And I actually remember playing Sly 2 after playing some, after, like, I mean, before, I mean, I remember playing Sly 3 after playing Sly 2, because I actually played Sly 3 first, and I saw, oh, there's actually bottles in here, that's weird, and whoa, how, what? Okay, the checkpoint right now is actually just showing it ran. Okay, there we go, there's the blimp we have to go, oh, fuck, I'm in a fucking pickle right here, let's just, kind of shoot this guy, thank you, because I do not want to deal with that flashlight guard. I'm fine with anything else, I just do not want to deal with the flashlight guard right now. And can I not get hit by this? And I did, and I'm out. Okay, then, anyways, because I'm... Oh, God, no knock, come on. This is just fan-frickin-tastic, if you know what I mean, right here. So, now we have to actually make our way up here. And hopefully I can make it there without dying, because I'm not in the mood for dying with Bentley today. And yes, I am going to be doing this whole thing, like, the rest of the mission in this episode. I know it's like 11 minutes, but whatever.
That's one of the engines that needs to be disabled. I won't lie to you, Murray. This is going to be a tough job that requires both our skills.
My skills? Okay, Bentley, if you say so.
First, best line ever right there.
Patience controlling access to the engine room. Then Murray, you'll need to head inside and use your muscle to finish the job.
The Murray will be ready to go.
And I forgot, I start with very little health, so okay, can these guys get away? See, can I snipe these guys? Oh, fuck, are you fucking kidding me? Oh, let's run, because I need to make it all the way over there without getting hit. So hopefully I will not get hit by there. And, oh, God. Okay, watch out the missiles. Okay, we made it to the first computer. Thank you. Now, once you go into this hacking mission, you're going to be seeing these hacking missions look a lot harder than the other ones. What you have to basically do here is just kind of, like, angle your shots like this. Just because angling your shots will actually kill these guys, and you do not want to actually go on like a heads-on attack on these things, because that's kind of just retarded, because these guys are actually very hard to get. Come on, get the guy, because this guy in the corner, okay, thank you. That guy in the corner is probably like the hardest one to get, and this is actually probably the hardest one to actually do here, just because the angling and stuff. So like I said, the angling's really not the easiest thing, and that actually went pretty good, but... I mean, it's actually pretty cool how they add the ricochet bullets, because if they didn't add it, you'd be, like, screwed here. Yeah, screwed, like that movie Scrooged, you're screwed, or whatever you want to call it. Let's just kill these guys. Come on, let's angle it, like, right there. Okay, no, I need to angle it more towards an angle. Wait, I usually end up, like, killing the other guys, as you see, right at the top before this guy, because some of these angles are just so stubborn to actually just perfectly make, so you have to be kind of very careful. And why aren't they going fully to that way? Come on. Whatever, I don't care, I just want to kill this guy. Thank you, that's better. Now I can just kind of angle it a little bit right there, and that guy, there we go, okay. And that is all we have to do here, that's all this hacking mission. I mean, well, there's three hacking computers you have to do, and you have to do them in a certain order, but whatever, that's all done with that. And surprisingly, the red ones don't go at, like, farther in or whatever, I don't know, but okay, I'm pretty sure I have to actually go over this way to actually get to the next one. I don't know, but I'm just guessing, you know, because guessing, it always solves every... Come on! I hate how many guards are on here. I hate the guard. Oh, fuck. Why am I getting screwed? Just kill me. Thank you, okay. I just want full health, and I want to be killed, because Bentley doesn't deserve to live. Nah, I'm just kidding. I went a little too far there. I mean, I actually purposely went too far there, but whatever. Now, come on! Damn guards! I hate the placement of some of these guards at times. And, like, right there, that placement's probably the most dickish placement ever. There's probably another helicopter guy following me, isn't there? Okay, I actually got away from them, okay. Jordan, don't stress, this game is not that hard. It's not like some other games, like, I can't think of other games that I would probably say for that. And I hate going through these as the other characters because you can't actually go precise platforming with Sly. And this, you just have to kind of like jump over like that. You don't have to, but that's the way I actually get over to this computer. Now, let's go and hack this computer here, which is actually a little bit different. There are still the big guys. I'm pretty sure the next one does not have the big guys. Just the next one is definitely a lot harder. So what we have to do here is we have to actually watch out for these like homing guys right there. But we still have to actually kind of kill these guys too. So once they're not coming, you just want to kind of like rampage them, like rampage the shooter, big shooter bullets, so you can just get them out of the way, and then just keep shooting these guys, which is pretty easy. Well, God. Oh, God, okay, that was pretty close. And why am I talking like this? I don't know why I'm talking like this. And oh, God, okay, are these guys are coming, okay. Now, as you see, because as you do that, those things actually come out, which is, like, I'm pretty sure you know, because we've done kind of these ones before. Wait, why is there... I thought there was two of those like that. Either this is supposed to be the first one you do, or I accidentally somehow killed that one guy with just randomly shooting. I don't know what happened, but whatever, I'll take it. And this one didn't take even close to as long as the other one. And wait, am I actually going to... Oh, I forgot. There's this thing right here. I was going to say, can I actually get through this without getting hit? But I'm probably not. And these things go a lot... Okay, I jinxed myself. But whatever, I really don't care. It's not like you get anything if you do this perfectly. I'm pretty sure you don't. Because I've done a lot of hacking missions perfectly before. And there's no skill points in this game for like hacking and stuff. I don't know. But anyways, we got that hacking done. Man, 15 minutes. Yeah, we're gonna finish this part with flying colors too. But then again, there is a cutscene after we do through here. But okay, whoa, we have a lot of tracking to do, and I have to wait for this. So random speed up. Okay, damn, that took a while to go there. Holy God, this thing moves slower than slow. That's slow as molasses. Damn it. Okay, but the next one is way over there, and I hate how the save point goes there. But whatever, I'm pretty sure it's somewhere here. Oh yeah, I forgot. This is actually the, like, this, where the computer is actually where the engine room, like, lock is. Because this is the one we have to actually do to actually unlock the thing for the Murray to get through, I think. At least I think it is. I don't know, but I don't know. And, ooh, God, now this is the one I hate. Also, say bravo, because this is actually the... Actually, don't say bravo, because these missions have been awesome, but this is the last hacking you ever have to do with Bentley in this game. Yeah, and you're not going to be seeing it that much in the next game, because the next game had, like, horrible with this, and holy God, I forgot there's these guys that come out. I thought they were the smaller guys, but they're not the smaller guys. And, whoa, God, I need to angle these, because what you have to do is you have to slowly progress forward like this. You have to slowly progress forward while you're shooting. And then you can actually, you want to kind of, like, keep these guys back or whatever. They will kind of, like, try to, well, God, I need to keep these guys back here. And, okay, that's good. Now I just need to kind of kill these guys here. Well, God, okay. Oh, God, that was close. Why do I keep saying that's close? I don't know. It's just because I really do not like this hacking mission right here. And, okay, come on. Just kill this guy. I hate how they keep rapidly shooting. And I hate how I'm like, you always get stuck here. Whoa, stop shooting like that. Okay, stop shooting like that. I need to actually move forward, but it's kind of hard to move forward when these guys keep like totally scrunching you in. But I've beaten this before here, so I know how to actually get through here. And oh God, I'm not doing good. I'm not doing good. And okay, come on, kill this guy right here. Okay, thank you. Now we can kind of angle these right there. And I'm screwed. I'm dead. Oh God, how the hell did I get past that? And come on. I'm just gonna cut out until I actually get close to this. Fuck. Okay, and I did this with like flying colors right here. Damn. That was like, I did that without commentating. I beat that like super fast. Damn. I don't even know how I did it that fast with like not commentating. I really didn't want to commentate for that because that one's actually a little bit hard of a hacking mission. And now we have to put our brute strength to the test here by lifting up these crates, which I'm pretty sure after you lift up a crate, a guard comes after you. But I'm not so sure. I'm pretty sure we can actually lift this one right here before the guard actually comes and tries to kill us. I mean, it's probably not the best idea to do this. And how did I do? Okay, I just got that. Whatever. Now where's the other guard? Because they do. I mean, like they only come out after you lift up one, so it's a little bit tedious of a process. But you just have to keep mashing the buttons as fast as you can. And yeah, and this episode's going to be one that actually goes over 20 minutes. It's just because, well, I don't know. I want to get the two missions done in this episode just because I don't want to deal with them later. I mean, I don't want to deal with like another episode because I wouldn't have like the next two missions after that because I'm pretty sure this is the last episode before the finale is out. And I'm pretty sure I can get this one before the guard comes. And okay, that's not it. I thought that'd be it, but wait, where's the... Oh, yeah, I forgot. Another guard. Forgot. I keep forgetting when you do two at a time, you have to actually do it. Well, two at a time, every single time. I should not have said that because that's a ripoff of a famous LP. Almost like somewhat famous, but is a famous LP here. So why did I almost say somewhat famous? Because it's not somewhat famous, and I hate these guards. Whoa, that was a little close call right there. I still have two to do? No, I want to get this, okay. I didn't know I still had two of these to do. I don't know why they put so many of these lifting crate things up, and I'm pretty sure I can get this one without having to deal with the guard, just because the guard's too far away from me, so I can actually get that. And yay, and okay, I believe those actually just stop that. Oh God, get up here, because I do not want that guard to mess with me. And now, let's smash these things back down to the ground, because that's what we have to do. Now, since we lifted them up, we have to smash them into the ground. Don't ask how it makes sense. It makes sense in some way. I don't know how it makes sense, but it makes sense. The only thing you have to do, like I said, is just smash these things like that. And I'm pretty sure this is the last one. Yep. Who, smashing those things down the ground is just a lot faster than just regularly going through here. And now let's disable the last of the engines. Awesome.
Another engine bites the dust.
And now that's job complete and cutscene.
In an unexpected windfall, I've been contacted by Inspector Fox over the shortwave radio. She's well aware of the dire situation we all face if Plakala becomes immortal and has agreed to join forces with us so that we can destroy the robotic bird. The only catch is that she's unable to locate this blimp on her radar. To help her hone in on our position, we'll need to boost the strength of 4 local radio towers. Once Inspector Fox is in range, she'll take one of us on board to act as a tail gunner in a dogfight against Plakala. This is it. We don't have time for another plan. We're almost over Paris, and if that hate hypnosis light show goes off, well, you know the story.
So yep, we are down to the final stretch in this game. We only have 2 more missions to do. One actually ends with the job complete, but we have 2 more missions to do, then this game is done. So anyways, in the next episode, let's play Sly 2 Band of Thieves. We are going to be doing Mega Jump Job and seeing why we have this weird pack thing on our back. So this has been Demon Razorblade, saying see you later and goodbye.